Montreal Canadiens. The Montreal Canadiens. The club's official name is. The team is frequently referred to in English and French as the Habs. French nicknames for the team include Les Canadiens, Le Bleu-Blanc-Rouge, La Sainte-Flanelle, Le Tricolore, Les Glorieux, Le CH, Le Grand Club and Les Habitants. Founded in 1909, the Canadiens are the longest continuously operating professional ice hockey team worldwide, and the only existing NHL club to predate the founding of the NHL. One of the oldest North American professional sports franchises, the Canadiens' history predates that of every other Canadian franchise outside football as well as every American franchise outside baseball in the National Football League's Arizona Cardinals. The franchise is one of the original six teams, a description used for the teams that made up the NHL from 1942 until the 1967 expansion. The team's championship season in 1992-93 was the last time a Canadian team won the Stanley Cup. The Canadiens have won the Stanley Cup more times than any other franchise. They have won 24 Stanley Cups, 23 of them since the founding of the NHL and 22 of them since 1927, when NHL teams became the only ones to compete for the Stanley Cup. On a percentage basis, as of 2014, the franchise has won 25.3% of all Stanley Cup championships contested after the Challenge Cup era, making it the second most successful professional sports team of the traditional four major sports of Canada and the United States, behind only the Boston Celtics. The Canadiens also had the most championships by a team of any of the four major North American sports until the New York Yankees won their 25th World Series title in 1999. Since 1996, the Canadiens have played their home games at Bell Centre, originally known as Molson Centre. The team previously played at the Montreal Forum, which housed the team for 7 decades and all but their first 2 Stanley Cup championships. The Canadiens were founded by J. Ambrose O'Brien on December 4, 1909, as a charter member of the National Hockey Association, the forerunner to the National Hockey League. It was to be the team of the Francophone community in Montreal, composed of Francophone players, and under Francophone ownership as soon as possible. The team's first season was not a success, as they placed last. After the first year, ownership was transferred to George Kennedy of Montreal and the team's fortunes improved over the next seasons. The team won its first Stanley Cup championship in the 1915-16 season. In 1917, with 4 other NHA teams, the Canadiens formed the NHL, and they won their first NHL Stanley Cup during the 1923-24 season, led by Howie Morins. The team moved from the Mount Royal Arena to the Montreal Forum for the 1926-27 season. The club began the 1930s decade successfully, with Stanley Cup wins in 1930 and 1931. The Canadiens and its then Montreal rival, the Montreal Maroons, declined both on the ice and economically during the Great Depression. Losses grew to the point where the team owners considering selling the team to interests in Cleveland, Ohio, though local investors were ultimately found to finance the Canadiens. The Maroons still suspended operations, and several of their players moved to the Canadiens. Led by the punchline of Maurice Rocket Richard, Toblake and Elmer Latch in the 1940s, the Canadiens enjoyed success again atop the NHL from 1953 to 1960. The franchise won 6 Stanley Cups, including a record 5 straight from 1956 to 1960, with a new set of stars coming to prominence: Jean Béliveau, Dickie Moore, Doug Harvey, Bernie Boom Boom Jaffer Young, Jacques Plante and Richard's younger brother, Henri. The Canadiens added 10 more championships in 15 seasons from 1965 to 1979, with another dynastic run of 4 straight cups from 1976 to 1979. In the 1976-77 season, the Canadiens set 2 still-standing team records, for most points, with 132, and fewest losses, by only losing 8 games in an 80-game season. The next season, 1977-78, the team had a 28-game unbeaten streak, the second longest in NHL history. The next generation of stars included Guy Lafleur, Yvonne Cournoyer, Ken Dryden, Pete Maholvlik, Jacques Lemaire, Pierre LaRouche, Steve Shutt, Bob Gainey, Serge Savard, Guy Lapointe, and Larry Robinson. Scotty Bowman, who would later set a record for most NHL victories by a coach, was the team's head coach for its last 5 Stanley Cup victories in the 1970s. The Canadiens won Stanley Cups in 1986, led by rookie star goaltender Patrick Roy, and in 1993, continuing their streak of winning at least one championship in every decade from the 1910s to the 1990s. In 1996, the Habs moved from the Montreal Forum, their home during 70 seasons and 22 Stanley Cups, to Molson Center. Following Roy's departure in 1995, the Canadiens fell into an extended stretch of mediocrity, missing the playoffs in four of their next 10 seasons and failing to advance past the second round of the playoffs until 2010. By the late 1990s, with both an ailing team and monetary losses exacerbated by a record low value of the Canadian dollar, Montreal fans feared their team would end up relocated to the United States. Team owner Molson Brewery sold control of the franchise and the Molson Center to American businessman George N. Gillett Jr. in 2001, with the right of first refusal for any future sale by Gillett and a condition that the NHL Board of Governors must unanimously approve any attempt to move to a new city. Led by President Pierre Boivin, the Canadiens returned to being a lucrative enterprise, earning additional revenues from broadcasting and arena events. In 2009, Gillett sold the franchise to a consortium led by the Molson family, which included the Woodbridge Company, BCE/Bell, the Fonds Solidarité FTQ, Michael and Lauer, Luke Bertrand and the National Bank Financial Group for $575 million, more than double the $275 million he spent on the purchase 8 years prior. During the 2008-09 season, the Canadiens celebrated their 100th anniversary with various events, including hosting both the 2009 NHL All-Star Game and the 2009 NHL Entry Draft. The Canadiens became the first team in NHL history to reach 3,000 victories with their 5-2 victory over the Florida Panthers on December 29, 2008. The Canadiens organization operates in both English and French. For many years, public address announcements and press releases have been given in both languages, and the team website and social media outlets are in both languages as well. At home games, the first stanza of O Canada is sung in French, and the chorus is sung in English. One of sport's oldest and most recognizable logos, the classic C and H of the Montreal Canadiens, was first used together in the 1917-18 season, when the club changed its name to Club de Hockey Canadien from Club Athlétique Canadien, before evolving to its current form in 1952-53. The H stands for hockey, not habitants, a popular misconception. According to NHL.com, the first man to refer to the team as the Habs was American Tex Rickard, owner of the Madison Square Garden, in 1924. Rickard apparently told a reporter that the H on the Canadian sweaters was for habitants. The team's colors since 1911 are blue, red, and white. The home sweater is predominantly red in color. There are four blue and white stripes, one across each arm, one across the chest and the other across the waistline. The main road sweater is mainly white with a red and blue stripe across the waist, red at the end of both arm sleeves, red shoulder yokes. The basic design has been in use since 1914 and took its current form in 1925, generally evolving as materials changed. Because of the team's lengthy history and significance in Quebec, the sweater has been referred to as the Canadiens used multiple designs prior to adopting the aforementioned design in 1914. The original shirt of the 1909-10 season was blue with a white C. The second season had a red shirt featuring a green maple leaf with the C logo, and green pants. Lastly, the season before adopting the current look, the Canadiens wore a barber pole design jersey with red, white and blue stripes, and the logo being a white maple leaf reading CAC, Club Athlétique Canadien. All three designs were worn during the 2009-10 season as part of the Canadiens' centenary. The Canadiens' colors are a readily identifiable aspect of French Canadian culture. In the short story The Hockey Sweater, Rock Carrier described the influence of the Canadiens in their jersey within rural Quebec communities during the 1940s. The story was later made into an animated short, The Sweater, narrated by Carrier. A passage from the short story appears on the 2002 issue of the Canadian $5 bill. Nos bras mirtres vous tendent le flambeau, à vous toujours de la porter bien haut. To you from failing hands we throw the torch. Be yours to hold it high. The motto is from the poem In Flanders Fields by John McCrae, which was written in 1915, the year before the Canadiens won their first Stanley Cup championship. The motto appears on the wall of the Canadiens' dressing room as well as on the inside collar of the new Adidas 2017-18 jerseys. Beginning in the 2004-05 NHL season, the Canadiens adopted Yuppie as their official mascot, the first costumed mascot in their long history. Yuppie was the longtime mascot for the Montreal Expos baseball team, but was dropped from the franchise when they moved to Washington, D.C. in 2004 and became the Washington Nationals. With the switch, Yuppie became the first mascot in professional sports to switch leagues. The Canadiens have developed strong rivalries with two fellow Original Six franchises, with whom they frequently shared divisions and competed in postseason play. The oldest is with the Toronto Maple Leafs, who first faced the Canadiens as the Toronto Arenas in 1917. The teams met 15 times in the playoffs, including 5 Stanley Cup finals. Featuring the two largest cities in Canada and two of the largest fan bases in the league, the rivalry is sometimes dramatized as being emblematic of Canada's English and French linguistic divide. From 1938 to 1970, they were the only two Canadian teams in the league. The team's other Original Six rival are the Boston Bruins, who since their NHL debut in 1924 have played the Canadiens more than any other team in both regular season play and the playoffs combined. The teams have played 34 playoff series, 7 of which were in the finals. The Canadiens also had an interprovincial rivalry with the Quebec Nordiques during its existence from 1979 to 1995, nicknamed the Battle of Quebec. Montreal Canadiens games are broadcast locally in both the French and English languages. CHMP 98.5 is the Canadiens' French language radio flagship. As of the 2017-18 season, the team's regional television in both languages, and its English language radio rights, are held by Bell Media. CKGM, TSN Radio 690, is the English language radio flagship. It acquired the rights under a 7-year deal which began in the 2011-12 season. In June 2017, Bell Media reached a 5-year extension. Regional television rights in French are held by Réseau des Sports under a 12-year deal that began in the 2014-15 NHL season. A sister to the English language network TSN, RTS was the only French language sports channel in Canada until the 2011 launch of TVA Sports, and was also the previous national French rights holder of the NHL. As a result, the Canadiens forewent a separate regional contract, and allowed all of its games to be televised nationally in French as part of RDS's overall NHL rights. With TVA Sports becoming the national French rights holder in the 2014-15 season through a sublicensing agreement with Sportsnet, RDS subsequently announced that a 12-year deal to maintain regional rights to Canadiens games not shown on TVA Sports. As a result, games on RDS are blacked out outside the Canadiens' home market of Quebec, Atlantic Canada and parts of Eastern Ontario shared with the Ottawa Senators. At least 22 Canadiens games per season, including all playoff games, are televised nationally by TVA Sports. TSN2 assumed the English language regional television rights in the 2017-18 season, with John Bartlett on play-by-play, and Dave Poulin, Mike Johnson and Craig Button on color commentary. All other games, including all playoff games, are televised nationally by Sportsnet or CBC. Bartlett returned to Sportsnet over the 2018 off-season, and was succeeded by Brian Mudrick. English-language regional rights were previously held by Sportsnet East, under a 3-year deal that expired after the 2016-17 season. The games were called by Bartlett and Jason York. Prior to this deal, TSN held the rights from 2010 through 2014. The games were rebroadcast on a part-time channel with Dave Randorf on play-by-play. This is a list of the last 5 seasons completed by the Canadiens. For the full season-by-season history, see list of Montreal Canadiens seasons. Note, GP equals games played, W equals wins, L equals losses, T equals ties, OTL equals overtime losses, PTS equals points, GF equals goals for, GA equals goals against. The Canadiens have retired 15 numbers in honor of 18 players, the most of any team in the NHL. All of the honorees were born in Canada. Howie Morin's was the first honoree, on November 2, 1937. The NHL retired Wayne Gretzky's number 99 for all its member teams at the 2000 NHL All-Star Game. The Montreal Canadiens have an affiliation with a number of inductees to the Hockey Hall of Fame. 64 inductees from the players category are affiliated with the Canadiens. 36 of these players are from 3 separate notable dynasties, 12 from 1955 to 1960, 11 from 1964 to 1969, and 13 from 1975 to 1979. Howie Morenz and Georges Vezina were the first Canadians given the honour in 1945, while Mark Recchi was the most recently inducted, in 2017. Along with players, a number of inductees from the Builders category are affiliated with the club. The first inductee was Vice President William Northey in 1945. The most recent inductee was head coach Pat Burns in 2014. In addition to players and Builders, five broadcasters for the Montreal Canadiens were also awarded the Foster Hewitt Memorial Award from the Hockey Hall of Fame. The first two recipients of the award were Danny Gallivan and René Le Cavalier in 1984. The other three award recipients include Doug Smith, Dick Irvin Jr., and Gilles Tremblay. These are the top 10 point scorers in franchise history. Figures are updated after each completed NHL regular season. Note: POS equals position, GP equals games played, G equals goals, A equals assists, PTS equals points, PG equals points per game. No wiki less than slash no wiki indicates a league record. No wiki less than slash no wiki indicates a league record. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.